Transportation Committee, and to my left, Senator Martin DeLon, who's a ranking member, and to my right is Senator Toby Stavisky. Thank you very much. And today we will consider the nomination of three individuals for the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. And the first is a reappointment of the Commissioner, Scott Reckler. Good morning, Mr. Reckler.
Good morning, Mr. Reckler.
Well, thanks for being here. If you could just, you know, Mr. Reckler was here last year, if we remember. We really didn't tell him much about the Port Authority, and he jumped into it. He's done a very good job, and I must say I admire your commitment and the time you've given to the Authority, and we really appreciate your tenure and your willingness to continue to serve. Just for the members that are here and the public, because this is the most watched show right now throughout the entire nation, if you could just give us a little brief background of what you've experienced in your first year.
Sure. I appreciate the confidence of the nomination last year. As the Senator said, I didn't really have a great appreciation for what the Port Authority was all about and how important it was to the region, to the economic engine that drives the region with all the infrastructure and support that it provides, as well as some of the challenges that it's been facing. And I think in the first year at the Port Authority, it would be defined as trying to open up the transparency and unveil challenges so we could put the Port Authority on the right course of action. And starting with, unfortunately, having to have a toll increases to do with some financial challenges, and then deciding to bring in third-party auditors to help us really understand what the issues were and let the public understand what the issues were. I think that was a first step of a prescription to making the Port Authority a much healthier, much more effective agency. We're completed that first step. We're actually now close to having the auditors present their second phase of their report, which is going to be more of a roadmap of going forward from their findings rather than just their findings themselves. And with that, along with the benefit of having the executive director, Pat Foy, there has been very effective, very committed, very energetic, and a board that I would say, both from New York and New Jersey, very aligned in taking a progressive approach and trying to tackle challenges and not let business be same as usual. And if it doesn't make sense just because it was done a certain way in the past, we're not going to do it that way in the future is the approach we're taking. So I think we have a good team, a refreshing team in place, and I think a lot of positive energy and momentum to overcome some of the challenges and put this 90-year-old agency
Well, I want to thank the governor for sending us your renomination to the commission. As I mentioned to you before, we had the opportunity to have the executive director, Pat Foy, come before the Transportation Committee yesterday. And it's refreshing, Mr. Reckler, what we heard. Certainly back on the right track. I concluded my meeting yesterday by saying all we've heard about in the last couple of years is a lack of transparency, fraud, waste, and abuse, and an authority that was just running amok. And the cost overruns, as you know, are in the billions for certain projects. We were very disappointed with the toll increase. We're not members of the commission. You know the finances better than we do. We ask that as you go forward, you take into consideration the economy, the economic conditions, and what the residents can afford, what they can't afford, as well as businesses. And interstate commerce is critically important, as you know, to moving our economy. Any comments or questions from any members?
Can I ask a quick question? I know you're from the island.
Yes.
How do you see Queens West progressing? Because I know the Port Authority has a role with the state EDC in its development.
Right. I don't think we have that much on Queens West in Portland, but I do have a view. Personally, I think Queens West, and you've seen all of the infrastructure projects that have been happening in the city, from the Queens West to the transportation systems that have been put in place, the 7 Line, the East Side Access, that, again, not the Port Authority offices, but have made a significant difference here. My private sector life, I run a large real estate company, and I will tell you that I've seen over the last 2 years a almost renaissance of companies and people that are coming and moving to New York that historically may not want to be there. And I really base it on the quality of life, the quality of our workforce, and the fact that we actually have infrastructure, investment, and transportation. transportation that make that wildlife more effective. They've opened up new areas, and I think Queens West and Brooks in Brooklyn is providing a neighborhoods with affordable housing for workers that are coming here, young workers that can't afford necessarily to live in Manhattan, and yet still have that, that sense of character and access to transportation. So it's been very, very effective, I think.
I obviously represent the streets of Queens, and I'm concerned about development, the jobs that it creates, and the housing opportunities.
That's right.
The infrastructure investment is so critically important for rebuilding our economy here. We ask that you watch the dollars, and we never get into a situation like we have with the overruns that we've witnessed. I want to thank you again for your willingness to serve. I know Senator DeLon does as well.
Sure. I just want to congratulate you and thank you for your service.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Just going to ask you to step back for a few minutes. Thank you.
It's going to be a tough decision.
All in favor?
Aye.
The appointment of Scott Howard Retro as Commissioner to the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey is hereby approved and referred to finance. Scott, congratulations.
Thank you. Let's sort of follow up this question.
I'd say that was a quick vote.
Now it's going to go to finance. His finance schedule is going to go for Wall Street.
Just
tell Scott.
Yeah. It's not scheduled.
No. But probably all of them. Yeah. Nomination to the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. This is Senator Stavisky to my right, Senator DeLon to my left. We'd ask that you just give us a brief overview of your experience and your desire to serve on the commission.
Well, I am the publisher and CEO of NDIO. NDIO, we're 100 years old next year, after 16 years. And prior to that, I worked in the New York media for last 27 years. I also did stint in government, where I spent 3 years at the New York City Health and Hospitals Corporation. I was in charge of all marketing and public affairs for the agency that is in the healthcare system. And I did that 1 year on the Dignus and 2 years on the GM. It was fascinating at that time to watch the transition in government. I also, those 3 years, I met some of the most brilliant people I ever worked with in government, and so I have always wanted to serve in the capacity of some commission like this. The Port Authority, so I'm really excited about this particular appointment, but also at this moment in time where both the governor of New York and New Jersey have made it a priority to not just, you know, impose change, but to really look for those things that unite us as opposed to the things that separate us geographically. So I've been here for 16 years. During that time, we've had three transitions in ownership. So it's like being a Yankee. And I'm really excited. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Great. Well, we want to thank Governor Cuomo for your nomination to the committee and your willingness to serve. Yesterday, we had the Executive Director, Pat Foy, before us. Give a very impressive presentation on the changes that have come to the Port Authority in a short time during his tenure. We ask that you watch the finances. It's critically important that there is transparency and accountability to the public that pays the fees that support the Port Authority, as you know, and you and I have discussed this. And we ask you watch that. That's very important. Residents can't afford any more tolls, any more fees, and we're very cognizant of that as a state legislature and a government under the leadership of Governor Cuomo. We ask that you take his direction on steering the Port Authority back in the right track. We believe it is. But we never want to go back to all the fraud, waste, and abuse, and the bad articles and cost overruns that we've experienced for far too long. Pat Foy, I believe, has done an excellent job in a short term there, and we thank you for your willingness to serve.
Senator Gordon? Just want to congratulate you and thank you for your service. Thank you.
Senator?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm not going to ask you to step out because I know what the decision is going to be, but I ask that nomination for Rosanna Rosato as a member of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey Commissioners. Is there a motion to move it?
So moved.
So moved. Second.
Second.
All in favor? Aye. And with the proxy votes we have, I offer my congratulations
to you.
You are now being referred to the Finance Committee.
Okay.
Thank you. James Rubin. And thank you for coming before the committee. To my far right is Senator Perkins. I just wanted to introduce the members of the committee. To his left is Senator Stavisky, and to my left is Senator DeLon, who's the ranking member of the Transportation Committee. We are here to consider the nomination of James Rubin as a commissioner of the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey. We thank you for your willingness to serve the people of New York State and New Jersey as well. But I'd ask if you just give us a brief overview of your background experience.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman and the Senators. Thank you for holding this hearing. I have some experience in the federal government. I left university. I worked in Washington for 16 years, worked for the Clinton administration for 7.5 years, and also worked in the Senate Foreign Relations Committee for 4 years. So I have a pretty good sense of both the legislative and the executive side of the federal government, and really enjoyed that experience. I've been a commentator on foreign affairs since then. I'm very pleased that Governor Cuomo has asked me to serve as confirmed at the Port Authority.
Well, thank you very much. You know, yesterday, and you and I talked about it briefly, we had the pleasure of having the Executive Director, Pat Foy, come before the Transportation Committee and give us an in-depth presentation on where the Port Authority was, where it is today, and where it's going. And I must say the report was, his comments were very impressive about how things have changed at the Port Authority. In the past, we've just had media reports and financial reports about waste, fraud, and abuse, and cost overruns into the billions. And we recently had a Port Authority before your tenure had imposed a toll increase, which I oppose, and sort of many members here. The economy is really bad, as you know, and our constituents throughout New York State just can't afford to pay anymore. We ask that you watch the finances and ensure that the Port Authority never goes back to the practices of the past. And I believe with Pat Foy as the helm, we will not see that again. I don't know if any members have any comments or questions. Senator Perkins.
I appreciate the I also just wanted to get a sense of this extraordinary resume, and wondering with this resume, what do you plan on doing at the fourth time?
You never know about New Jersey.
Well, thank you, Senator. Governor Cuomo, when I met with him, he suggested this idea really put an emphasis on the port as a method for improving the economy of New York and New Jersey. I strongly believe that America's competitiveness is partly related to having the best possible infrastructure. And as the rest of the world has improved to become our competitors, we will be better off if we have infrastructure that can handle and compete in a world where we have real competitors. So I'm hoping that my international experience can help me a bit in understanding the competition that New York faces as a port, and obviously in the other areas as well, and also in the security area where, you know, there are a lot of new issues out there in security that never existed before that I have some background in the federal government and the Senate. I hope to be able to contribute. An example of that would be the whole cybersecurity issue, which I won't take up too much of the members' time, but just to say that the Port Authority did it. I went to an exercise, and they looked into the future, and they said, what could the world look like if India and China really took off and started growing? And one of the areas where America could have a competitive advantage is if we get ahead of the others on security matters. So that's an example of the kind of thinking that I hope to bring to bear, but I will always obviously remember that this organization, everyone, you come up to someone and say, I'm going to work for the Port Authority, and they say what the chairman just said about his finances, about his problems, about the tolls. And I think until that's reinvented and reinvigorated in the way that Mr. Floyd would do, I think some of the more far-reaching ideas I mentioned, obviously,
Thank you. Senator Stavisky.
No, we just thank you for your willingness to serve and sort of
Director Foy.
More mundane than foreign policy. Do you have any thoughts on that Hudson Tunnel that Governor Christie has rejected?
I have not gotten a briefing about it, and I know that finding a way to make sure that New York and New Jersey are working well together is obviously crucial, but I haven't studied it. I would be happy to get back to you if I did.
That's a question more for the chairman.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Director Foy, in his statement yesterday, emphasized the capital investments that the Port Authority is making over the next few years. Critically important to revitalizing and rebuilding our economy is the infrastructure improvements. We ask that you keep an eye on that. Tens of thousands of jobs that will be created in the region are important to our economy. But also, for those that pay fees for the Port Authority, the accountability and transparency is equally as important as well. Senator DeLong?
I just want to say congratulations and thank you for your service.
I'm not going to ask you to step out, but I'm going to ask if there's a motion on the nomination of James Rubin to the Port Authority of New York and New Jersey as a commissioner. Motion is made. All in favor?
Aye.
Mr. Rubin, congratulations.
Thank you.
Your nomination has been approved by the Transportation Committee. You now will be referred to the Finance Committee.
Oh, thank you.
Best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Jamie. This concludes the meeting of the Transportation Committee. Thank you very much for your attendance.